I didn't take a chance to use my name. And for those who don't know who I am, I am Carol Block. And this is our 16th season of doing recitals. And I'm so glad you all could come. I think I just put you into two groups. I think that this recital and then the other group is going to come. So anyway, welcome, and it's kind of bittersweet. This is, my husband will be stepping down July 31st, so I sort of have to step down with him. I don't think they'll let me stay here. Nice to squat, but that's okay. he'll be still on the faculty, and I think he'll probably want to take a year sabbatical. He'll kind of get lost somewhere. So anyway, enjoy this concert. This is a real special treat. You don't get the Chinese music too many places. And make sure your cell phones are all turned off, please. I appreciate it. And at the bottom says no photography or video or recording. So I will let the students come in and I'll talk to you. Thank you.
Chinese traditional flute, and in Chinese it is called Di Zi, and it is kind of like the Western flute. It's like kind of like the same, but the only difference is like for Western flute we need to like push the button in order to play it, but like for Chinese traditional flute it's like holes, so it's like kind of different. And then the music that I'm playing, it is called Spring to Shenzhen River, and then hope you guys like it. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm first year in Anderson, and I'm going to play this instrument, which is called zheng. So this instrument has maybe more than 3,000 years of history. It actually originated from another instrument, it's called se. So that is 3,000 years ago. And this is, I think, probably 1,000 to 2,000 years ago. And it has 21 strings. But then the se I was mentioning, well, it has 50 strings. But yeah, there's a lot of them. Yeah, and there's a poem saying that because the se is too melodramatic, too sad, so they just cut it to half. So the zheng we have right now is less sad. And the piece I'm going to play is called The Spring in Snowy Mountains. It's a very beautiful scene in the Tibetan area. So when the spring comes, we do have snow mountains here. So the snow will melt, you will hear a little bit of that kind of sound, and people will come and play and enjoy the beginning of the new year. Yeah.
Thank you.
very interesting, and there are a lot of beautiful pieces. So next we'll have Casey to play her piece Yu Zhou Tao, and she'll introduce more. Thank you.
Thank you. everyone. My name is Yi. And the instrument I play is called Liu Qin. So it's really like a guitar, and it's Chinese guitar. So it's a talking instrument, and we just play it like that. Yeah.
Hi, everyone. My name is Guanning, and I'm a second year psychology major student. And the instrument that I play is called Zhong. My classmate has introduced it before. So
the piece we're going to play is called Zhong. So it is originally written by Ranji 2,000 years ago, and it is original Qin piece, so which played by Liu Qin. So now we move the music on to Liu Qin and Zhen.
It becomes a duet piece.
Yes.
And the composition is basically consists of seven chapters, or we can say seven parts, and it basically tells the story that Ranji used drunkenness to telling his rebellions to the rulers. Yeah. So, please enjoy.
Thank you.
considering these are, you know, instruments that that people don't often see, I'm sure there's a lot of questions in the audience. And would you mind if we spend a few minutes, Alex, if you could answer some questions? Anybody?
How is this instrument like the harp?
Like, we are all string instruments, of course, but for harp, I don't think you have this thing in the middle. So you kind of place the, we'll call it mat, so it supports the string, and you can move it like level right to adjust the tuning. Yeah, and then there's another way to tune it. Like, this is actually a box. Like, you can open it. And like, the string is attached here, so you can use a tuner to like, make it tighter, so it's higher pitch. So you can do it for all the strings.
Yeah, and
yeah, that's very good. Yeah.
Could you
take
that open?
Sorry?
Thank you. So
I think, yeah, this one also.
What inspired you to play such an instrument?
Oh, I actually just randomly walked into a music store, and my mom just asked me like, which one you like, and I like the sound of it. Yeah, that was like I was 5 years old. 5 years ago. Yeah, 5 year old. Yes. 5 years ago. Yeah. Yeah. Sorry.
Can you get these instruments here, or you import them, or you brought them with you, or?
That's a good question. We don't know the answer to that. Yeah. The instrument is provided by Professor Lee in ethnomusicology department. Oh. So we kind of borrow the instrument so that we can play. Oh. Yeah, but we have it like back home. Like.
Your instrument on the end, you said, reminds you of a guitar, but yeah. The way it looks, and the way it sounds, it was more like a mandolin.
Oh, yeah.
What do you think?
I don't know. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, sure. I was just like, usually people think, oh, I just went and used the word guitar, so. Yeah, but I agree with you.
All of you are majors in different departments, which I applaud you. But the instruments you play require a great deal of skill. So I wonder how many years or how old you were when you started studying this, if each or many of you could share that with us.
Okay, so I started to play the thing since the first grade, so in my primary school. And this is my own instrument, so I brought it from China. Because I think so those instruments are big, but this one's really like similar to violin, like the size, so I can bring it down a little bit.
I started to learn drum when I was about 4, and then when I entered second grade in my primary school, my parents told me to stop, and then I started to learn piano. Random change. But I think like from my deep heart, I still love drum because I think that's connected to my own culture. So I picked it up when I was about 6th grade, and then like keep learning it until now.
So unlike most of these people here, I actually grew up in California. I'm from the Bay Area, so this yangqing is actually also my own. I brought it down. I've been playing since I think I was 6. And because in the Bay Area, they have an orchestra, orchestra that teaches you Chinese instruments. So my parents, when I was 6, they're like, learn an instrument, pick one. That's the one I picked because it sat front and center in the middle of the orchestra.
For me, I learned flute like after elementary school, so till now it's like 6 years, I think. And then my flute is also my own flute. I also bought it in China. And then I have like 5 other different ones because like for a flute, it's like they can't really like change majors, so it's like one flute per major. And then the song what I just play is for E major. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. And then
I think I share my story just now. Yeah, just to add on, I really love the sound of it. I feel a connection, like I feel the identity.
Mm-hmm. It's hard to tell, but yeah, I think you feel it as well.
Do the instruments have a notation? Mm-hmm. Is there a traditional notation? And also, was this court music or folk music?
Oh.
Definitely we have a specific kind of notation. Actually, we use numbers, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Mm-hmm. We use that to represent
So one is like do, and then two is re, and then like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so that's why the do, re, mi, sol, la, ti, do.
How high do the numbers go?
Okay, so it just goes from 1 to 7, and then it's like go up an octave. You'll have like a 1 and then a dot on top.
Yeah.
So that would indicate like the difference between middle C and like an octave higher C.
And in terms of another question, the chord music or the folk song, I think we have both of them. Like some pieces are arranged from the chord music and some of them are folk songs. Like the piece that we just played, that's arranged from a poet called Ran Ji, and he's just a normal person. So that's kind of like a folk song, not a chord music. But yeah, we definitely have chord music.
Oh, so the score sheet music I was passing around is that one is for Zheng. So I think notation. Do you know the name for it?
The
Tian. Yes. Basically, we just use numbers. So 1 means Do, 2 means Re, things like that. Yeah. So and we like if you want to do 2 strings together, you just put it like up and down.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Two. Yeah, in the column. And the other sheet music I'm passing right here is it's sheet music for qin, which is also a very old instrument, 3,000 years ago. But we are not playing here. But I think that one is even more Chinese. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So and that one is not numbered. It's using like Chinese characters. So for example, you are doing this. We call it something. Then we have a Chinese character for that. Then you take half of it. Then the left hand you have other instruction. You take the other half of it. Then you put it together. So it's not really a character itself, but it's used by the musicians.
I noticed that some of the songs you didn't even have sheet music. How long did it take you to remember? Especially the two, so the ones that play together.
We started to practice it on the last quarter.
Last quarter.
Yes. I think so. This music is like modern and it's about rhythm, so it's not that really difficult. So we can remember it quickly, but usually mm-hmm. it takes like several months.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes. Do you, despite your very busy schedules, as students, do you have the opportunity to perform as an ensemble group? Do you have occasions to?
We welcome everybody to come to our Music China concert. It's actually a quarterly concert. Personally, I have participated twice. So it's, I think for this quarter, it's week 7. Yes.
It's May 18th.
Yeah.
I think it's 5 p.m. and I think it's in the Schoenberg Music Hall.
Yes. So that will be advertised in Schoenberg.
Yes, on the website. Yes. And it's free. We'll have like duets and like a group performance as well as ensemble pieces.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. So the additional instruments other than what you're playing here.
Yes, much more.
I know there's a one that looks like a lute and it's called the pisa.
Oh, yes.
I think it's a little bit bigger than And then the erhu, which plays kind of like a lot, like a fiddle.
Yeah,
three strings?
Two strings.
And a box attached.
Yes, a box.
Yeah. So as when you go in the foyer, there's a...
This is what an air moves. this long stick and two strings. And Professor Lee, who teaches the Chinese instrument, was a master of the erhu in China. She has quite a reputation. Anyway, this was given to us by a group of two Chinese graduates.
Oh, that's nice.
I just wanted to say, at your young age, your abilities to play like this is just outstanding.
Thank you very much for coming, and thank you to the students. And you can join us for a reception in the dining room, and we'll walk around the house or outside, and I hope the students will join us.
If anyone wants to try out.